Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming channel. So today I want to showcase a level 85 Ravina max limit break. And yeah, this is not my account, okay? So once again, Gumi lend me this account so that I can make the review video for this unit. And yeah, she is basically a Magia Gunslinger, but also have a Dark Cavalier Enchant Job Espion. So what is this Dark Cavalier Espion? Here we go. Dark Cavalier Espion, specialized movement and evasion. Okay. The assault now become Phantom Assault. Greatly raises own P attack and critical, and raises move by 1, but lower speed FM death. Okay. And then Moonlight Knight from Pitch Black Bloodline. Reduces HP cost for skills that consumes HP and raises agility and evasion rate. So, okay. Ravina is kind of like a fast Dark Cavalier. Okay, so the agility should be nice if I use this agility plus 10 gear. And yeah, now the agility is 139. Actually, this is a little bit sad for a Dark Cavalier enchant job that is specialized in agility and movement. Really? 139? Okay, what I mean is Anastasia have higher agility than this. Yeah, Anastasia's agility can hit 155 at max. Level 85 Anastasia with booster. 155 agility. So this one, well, it is actually slightly higher than the other Dark Cavaliers, which is nice actually, yeah. The good stuff for this Dark Cavalier is it has evasion. But too bad that the evasion rate is only 10%. Which is 10% lower than Twin Blades. So I don't think this is kind of like a reliable Dark Cavalier for the evasion. She will get hit just too many times, I think. But yeah, she has quick draw. Chance of performing a preemptive strike, range 5. This could be fun. I mean, before the enemy attack, she can attack first with this high P attack and stuff. Oh yeah, the P attack is only 653 by the way. Which is kinda low for a Dark Cavalier. I mean, units like Sahar can reach more than 800. Can reach 900 actually. And Suzuka, almost 1000. Or maybe 1000 if I'm not wrong. Yeah. But yeah, honestly, this is kinda low for a Dark Cavalier. Okay. So that's stats-wise, by the way. But the max HP is actually pretty nice, 1400 with Alchemono. If it's with Wanderer set, 1200. Still kinda low, I think. Yeah, too low for current meta. She might going to get killed by Lahar. Especially if that Overlord dimension goes critical. Yeah, I don't think she won't survive, even though she is a water unit. Okay, so maybe it is still better to use her as Magia Gunslinger after all. Yeah, as a Magia Gunslinger, her damage is based on the magic attack. So yeah, basically you can use this gear, Battlefield Drama, to get magic attack 40. And I don't think you have to use these kind of pistols because they don't give magic attack like this one. No magic attack boost. So it is better to use camera if you have camera for the damage. I mean for additional damage. Modify missile attack plus 10. Her attacks are missile attacks, yeah. But based on magic attack. And yeah, she has fire, light, dark, and yeah, basically she has all element if you use a basic magic gun. Also, you can try to use basic Pitch Black Blade if you want to for the Blood Drain and Jewel Drain. I think the damage should be very nice because of she has very high magic attack. And the max HP is not really that high, 1150. I think this is kinda reasonable for a range attacker like her. Yeah, the recommended one is Overdrive and Magia Scope for maximum damage and range. Yeah, I think this is the best setup for her, and also Quick Draw because she is kinda squishy. Okay, anyway, let's just try to showcase her damage. So the leader skill, raises HP 30% and magic attack 20% for water units. This is a good leader skill for Noctis, Ultima, and Fengliu, and also Ilya's Veil, and also for Lovia. Yeah, we have a lot of strong water magic attackers in the game, so her leader skill could be quite useful. But how good is her own damage? That's what we want to know, actually. But honestly, I think we cannot expect high from her damage, because Magia Gunslinger, they are kinda basically for the status ailments, in my opinion. So the initial jewel is 68 with Wanderer set. Yeah, and she got magic attack boost from the leader skill. Okay, so her normal attack damage is 1395. Not bad for a ranged attacker. And the attack range is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5 tiles. And the first skill, Magia Shot, it has casting speed. Yeah, that's the only skill that has casting speed. The other 3 skills from the main ability doesn't have casting speed. So the damage is 2030. That's actually not bad at all. So yeah, this is the skill showcase. The MB cost was only 16, so maybe that's actually pretty nice, but casting, really? And then the second skill, Burning Shell, fire magic attack that inflict daze on target unit. Okay, so I think we can try to use it here to this enemy, 1676. Should be the same damage as this one, see? Yeah, so this is fire element and this 100% chance, but the damage is lower than the first skill, which is kinda too bad. If the damage is lower than the first skill, you know, very high chance that Ravina is just going to use the Magia Shot instead of Burning Shell. That's kinda too bad actually. Okay, the third skill, Laser Snipe. Penetrating light magic attack on target unit and raises own magic attack for 3 turns, range 5. Oh, it is penetrating, so... Whoa, it is just like Piercing Snipe, basically. The damage is 1818. And it will raise her magic attack. Okay, so now her magic attack is 1015. The magic attack boost is plus 30%, so I think that's nice. And the final skill, Hell Barrage. Dark magic attack 100% hit on target unit, range 5. Okay, good thing the damage is higher than Magia Shot. Okay, so she will use Hell Barrage if she has enough MP. And it is 100% hit rate, so... Wow, okay, this is a nice counter for those evasion characters. 2171 damage in this enemy. I wonder how high the damage if it's to characters like Uzuma. Oh, it can one hit KO this Uzuma. Really? Oh yeah, this is only 1162 max HP. Okay, so anyway, we can use this to kill evasion characters. Maybe. Yeah, I'm not really sure the damage on PvP, but honestly, I don't think she will be able to one-hit KO those tanky evasion characters. Now, the basic magic gun. Okay, so all of these four are actually can do the same damage. Flame Shot, let's use it to this dark enemy, 1100, right? Freezing Shot, 1100. Thunder Shot, 1100. And Storm Shot, the same 1100. So all of these do the same damage. But since she has water, the highest damage from all of these is Freezing Shot against fire enemy, 1822. And one last skill that I want to showcase is Battlefield Drama's master ability, Sinister's Gaze. Inflict dark magic damage on units facing target area. Since her magic attack is pretty high, I think the damage should be nice too. 1622. Not really that nice actually. 1800 to this enemy, to the water enemy. So yeah, still kind of lower than Magia Shot, and it is higher than Burning Shell Laser Snipe, but lower than the Hell Barrage. I think she is just going to use this if she can hit multiple enemy with this skill. She will just going to use this. Yep, that's the widest AoE from Ravina, which is from the Battlefield Drama's master ability. Okay, now let's try to use her as Dark Cavalier. I don't think her damage will be high, especially because of the P attack is only 653 and the leader skill doesn't boost P attack. So yeah, I don't think it will be that high. So the initial jewel is 64 as Dark Cavalier. The normal attack damage is 1301. Really? It is like around the same as the one from Magia Gunslinger. Oh, what? Juggernaut is 66. Okay. So she cannot use Juggernaut right from the first turn. Soul Sacrifice damage is 1800. Darkbringer. 1400. Wow, that's kinda low for a Dark Cavalier. Okay, what if I use this? Freezing Shot. 900. Okay, that's really low. And if I use Sinister's Gaze, 900. Wow, that's a very low damage from a Dark Cavalier. Kinda disappointing, but okay. Okay, Juggernaut's damage, 1961. Really? Okay, I think this is because of her leader skill doesn't boost any P attack. If it's maybe with at least plus 30% P attack boost, her damage should be around 3000? Yeah, the Juggernaut's damage should be around 3000. But that's still kinda disappointing for a Dark Cavalier class like her. But anyway, let's use it. Okay, honestly, I think she's kinda disappointing. Yep. Speaking of which job recommended for her is Magia Gunslinger, I think. This Dark Cavalier Espion is maybe only for some nice status boost. Okay, actually a nice damage as a magic attacker. I mean magic range attacker, but not satisfying enough. And yeah, the max HP is also kinda low. Yeah, the agility is not bad, 137, but still kinda far from awesome. Yeah, kinda disappointing. But I think she is somehow still usable for PvE contents. Yeah. She won't be that awesome for Arena, but I think she is going to be awesome for PvE. Oh yeah, speaking about Arena, she is actually quite usable for manual control Arena because of, you can use this. Burning Shell. It can instantly cast Daze to the enemy. The range is 5. This is dangerous. I will say this is very dangerous for manual control Arena. Especially if the enemy is not using something like Vaccine or Poison Pill. You can own the enemy using this Burning Shell. But other than that, I don't think she is that awesome. Maybe Hell Barrage could be very useful for the 100% hit rate, maybe to kill Wagi now? Yeah, but okay, overall I don't think she is that awesome at all. And yeah, of course, she doesn't worth the Water Shard. And in the future, she will be farmable. So yeah, once she has become farmable, I think it is okay, just try to raise her, limit break her with the free shards you get from the hard quest. But you don't have to force yourself to make her into level 75 like right now. Because even if you have her at level 75 or 85 like this, she won't be that useful in Arena. And also, even for PvE, you know, even though she's actually usable, There are many better water units than her. I mean in terms of damage. Especially magic damage. But I think somehow if we need water range attacker, maybe something like for that Fritz EX, the one to get Blanchette, I think she is usable. Yeah, she is very useful there, other than Archerin. Okay, that's what I think about Ravina. Yeah, so I think that's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe now if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye bye. The Alchemist Code Punch!